my third year in successful ability youth Y4IT on the West, and I'm going to be here again. The past 2 years, I was selling a company as a whole running the industry association, the business process association in the Philippines, and then moved to the private sector and joined the main company in the Philippines. And then, this is where my presentation will revolve around. It's basically the evolution of sales, the business development, and IT and BPO industry. See what people on the media said from a past of non-sales or pre-sales. Unfortunately, wouldn't you allow me that? Because it has evolved so much that I might introduce myself in the next year or two. Nowadays, it's not all about selling the services, selling the company. It's more about clients wish to talk about the people that deliver the service. So the specifics will go into the people in the delivery, people like him who's going to be a speaker later on, who is a solution service architect. And this is what my presentation is all about. And I hope you have it. So, of course, I'll have to put in a slide about Valpiva, the company I work for. Valpiva is a European heritage IT BPO company. We're heavy in Europe. We started in the Philippines in 2007, so we're going on our fourth year with 700 people. Mainly IT services, we have BPO services, consulting, we're also a system integrator. We have 40,000 employees, 40,000 employees in 36 countries, and our range of services again goes back to consulting, IT services, and BPO services. So, how has sales and business development evolved? Clients' needs have changed so much. As I mentioned earlier, I am in a Canadian sales side kasi bolero na yung sales side. Ang gusto nila, kausap ay hindi mga tao yung nag-deliver. So it's actually the people on the ground, the people that deliver the service delivery managers, the team leaders, the transition managers, the solution service architects, it's people that actually deliver the service. So this is a major point on what's going to happen in the next years to come. It's not how well you speak, it's about the quality of work that you actually deliver. Outsourcing versus offshoring. Let me give you, or I don't know if it is associated with UK or PIPA. The IT and BPO industry now in the Philippines employs close to about 500,000 people now. It started in the year 2000, some earlier, the boom really started in the year 2000. It's generating about $7.2 billion in revenues for the Philippines. This is not something to do the revenues of other sectors that generally come out of this industry. For example, the McDonald's, the Starbucks, the taxi drivers that now have a 24-hour shift. And it's geared to hit $12 billion in the next 3 years. So just imagine the number of people that will be employed in this industry. So outsourcing basically is client would want to outsource to a company that's a Valpiva. So before it needs to be just an outsource. Offshoring basically is like a company like US Auto Parts that actually set up themselves in the Philippines and move their back office operations, their application management services in the Philippines and are happy in doing that. Or a new thing that has evolved wherein clients actually come in and talk to outsourcing companies like Valpiva and come in a BOT model. BOT model is a build, operate, transfer. Where they're not sure whether they want to outsource or offshore to the Philippines, but they actually want to try it out first with an outsourcing company in a BOT model, wherein if I will get it delivered and after 2 years, if they wish to set up themselves, then they can actually just give back the service to them while they set up operations in the Philippines. If they're happy with the service with outsourcing partner, then they leave there. There's a flexibility between outsourcing and offshoring. Nearshore and offshore, big question. So, for example, clients that we have like Shell, British Telecom, sometimes clients are very conservative, especially European clients, very conservative with the life cycle of them on deciding whether it's offshore or outsourced to the Philippines 6 months a year. And with this, they actually think of nearshore before offshore. The next paper, I have a slide here. So as you can see, this is the footprint of what we have and where we are in all of those countries. And it shows you, color orange, are the nearshore sites. So we have nearshore sites in Czech Republic, we have in Morocco, Lebanon. These are nearshore options. And the offshore locations would be places like India, Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, and Brazil. So it just gives you a distinction because sometimes clients actually prefer because they're too conservative, they're too afraid of offshoring or going to an offshore country that they do nearshore. Full service offerings versus specialty niche players. So for technology offering example, we're all over the place. When we go to our client, initially we will offer them application management, whether it's development or maintenance type of work, and eventually when we build that client relationship, we actually then extend our service offerings. For example, this is what we do in Logica. It involves around BPO, IT, customer service desk operations, application maintenance, testing, infrastructure management, and the likes. And it evolves. So eventually, we offer the client a full spectrum of service animal. Well, an each player would be companies like Northgate, Rindo, which is in the Philippines as well, that specifically does HR services, the application side and also the BPO side. Blended delivery, hold on, let me go back. Full outsource and blended delivery. Now this is really a new thing for me. Before companies used to just fully outsource the services and decide what type of services they wish to outsource. In Brasilia, they outsource the media in HR payroll services, finance, accounting, maintenance, and support services before they actually find the confidence to actually outsource the development work. Well, then it is a really new thing. If a client actually is so conservative and so afraid to go to the Philippines, we offer them a blended delivery model. So a blended delivery model basically is, let's say a company or a client decides to outsource with Logica. And they say, well, I'm so afraid to send the application development so what we offer them is a blended delivery model where maintenance support and testing can be done in the Philippines and we leave the application development services in the UK till such time that the client is actually comfortable and moving on offshore. So in the time frame of 3 or 5 year contract, then we actually slowly gives them a cost benefit as eventually we move seats slowly back to the Philippines. So the percentages actually happens initially with a 40-60 split where 40% will be in the Philippines and eventually 20% will be nearshore, 80% offshore in the Philippines. So with the blended delivery model, again, you have the possibility to see as you have the account managers, service delivery managers onshore, on-site, easily accessible. You have the domain knowledge and its excellence and you have the operational cost efficiency as well. Global support in multiple countries. This is also quite new for me. I think we've learned this in the last 3 years. So for example, I want this opportunity to do application maintenance and support in an SAP background with this French client called Louis Vuitton. You probably heard of those expensive bags, LV bags. So we actually do the global multiple countries type maintenance and support. So we have the Philippines that's actually supporting Asia and Australia. We have Brazil that's supporting the US. And we have Morocco that's actually supporting France and the rest of Europe. So it evolves. You will have global contracts, multiple countries that are involved in one single client. Again, this gives you a global footprint that showcases how it will be designed and how multiple countries can work together for a single client. and what they want is to contracts before it reached me, 10 years, 8 years, 10 years, 12 years, 15 years, festival. Now clients get more conservative, they want more flexibility, these contracts are actually now on a 3 to 5 year maximum term, where it gives them flexibility if they're not satisfied with your service. Again, it goes back to the quality of service, they can actually easily talk to another provider. So, what will the future be like? What will be the future be like in the IT and BPO industry, in the sales arena? Consolidation, I think, will happen. You have seen a lot of call centers or BPO or IT companies buying other IT BPO companies to give them higher global footprint, to give them flexibility, and to bring in more innovation to the client. So consolidation will happen. Eventually, players will get bigger and bigger by either partnerships or actually buyouts. Everything in the future will be driven by innovation. I am telling you now, innovation is the way to go. Each employee should actually think how they can bring innovation to their team, that the team transmits to the client, that will actually deliver better quality of service. Technology-driven, adapting to the technology in the future. Delivery experience, global processes have to be in place. For multiple countries that you contact, you have to have global processes, there has to be a standard. Company with global footprints and partnerships. I know there are a lot of Filipino IT companies that have partners with IT companies in China, just to provide that global footprint where it can be serviced. And of course, everything as I mentioned earlier goes back to the quality of service. Now, this is probably the slide that will actually help, or my advice to all of you. So what are the skills that I believe all of our students, or most of our students, especially the IT arena, should have? First, this is what I never did, and unfortunately, I'm learning the hard way, and I'm only learning now. We all have to set goals. It's just like a company where we set mission and visions for the company. We have to set mission and vision for ourselves. You have to set goals. You have to be driven with those goals. You have to know what you want to do after you graduate, where you're going to be, where you're going to excel at, and what you want to focus on. Specialized skills. As the president of IBM said, we have to have smart skills. Smart skills, basically, we're focused, and it's very niche, and we drive at it. Whether you want to go into quality, whether you want to go into service delivery, whether you want to go into Oracle, SAP, get certifications. Industry-specific knowledge and certification, as I mentioned earlier, it's getting much known now in the industry that once you are a certified SAP BI consultant, you're making the big money. And this is what's in demand. So when you do graduate, there has to be that goal again, we'll start with the goal, to actually push through with certification. Business intelligence, and trust me on this, get experience. Don't be shy, don't be ashamed to actually start from the bottom. When you start from the bottom and excel upwards from there, there is so much opportunities. This is where everything, the knowledge, the trust, and that you will gain in order to excel in an IT company. So, what to look for in a company when you graduate? This is one of the things that you should also look at. So look at the quality and security standards that the company has. And some companies, 4 years, 5 years ago, it wasn't really that important to have quality standards, certifications, security certifications in place for companies. But what I'm noticing is it's getting very popular, and clients are actually demanding that the vendors that provide the service have these quality standards. So as an example, you have all these types of different standards that are in place. For people, you can get ITIL certification. For companies, you can actually look for, do they have ISO certifications? Do they have CMMI? For example, the Technology of Philippines, which is certified for CMMI Level 3 in service. I think we're the fourth in the world to get certified as a company, and it is mainly because driven by the client's request. Six Sigma, we have black belt Six Sigma experts that are actually implementing Six Sigma programs into our BPO and IT services, and all the other tools, which again goes around that evolves into standard processes. Find a company that will actually deliver value to the clients, to the owners, and to the people. Everything in this industry is about people. Philippines is known for the people. So how do we sell the Philippines? It goes back to the people. So it's the people focused on companies that are actually a good company to work for. They provide more benefits, work-life balance, training programs to enhance their skills. They provide succession planning that actually drives, people in their growth in the public company. Partnerships and certifications. So if you're outsourcing, if you plan to go to an outsourcing company, try to look for those outsourcing companies that are actually a partner, full partner of SAP, a global partner of Oracle, and the likes. Recession-proof client industry base. So if you do plan to go to an IT outsourcing company, try to look for that company that actually has clients that are focused on recession-proof. When I say recession-proof, that means they're actually handling government accounts, they're actually handling energy and utility accounts, they're actually handling transport or transportation accounts, they're actually handling telco accounts. These are accounts, these are client bases or industry client bases that are actually recession-proof, that has helped out the economy tough times like in 2009 during the recession. So, in summary, what can I say? If you do want to get into sales or business development into one, it can be an IT company, it can be an IT or BPO company, it can be a multinational local company, it can be working abroad. You have to actually have that specific skill in place. Hence, setting a goal. You have to have, the next one is, you have to have that mindset of always thinking what value proposition am I going to give to the client. It's all about value proposition. Specialized skills, the new breed of skills and business development, again, it goes to industry specific, it goes to your expertise that I mentioned earlier. You have to be an expert in business intelligence, and again, it drives back to client intimacy. Whoever has relationships or connections during the right time will get you moving the contracts or the projects. And lastly, as I mentioned earlier, there was only one person that actually put her hand up if she wanted to be sales or pre-sales. Guys, all of us have to be sales. In our company, in the rest of the IT BPO companies, and I know that Tim is going to elaborate on this more later in the next presenter from US Auto Parts, is all of us have to make sales people. The way we do it is we deliver as promised the service that will be required of us, and we sell ourselves to the rest of the world, to our clients, and believe me, it will happen for our people. Thank you very much. Thank you.